add users to special access in D2L assignment folders and quizzes. Special access allows you to set different conditions, usually involving time, for individual students. The two D2L tools that have special access built in at this time are assignment and quiz. Let's begin with assignments. Here are the steps that will be demonstrated. Go to Assignments, edit an assignment submission folder by using the drop-down menu, which is a black triangle. In the Restrictions tab, click Add Users to Special Access. Choose the dates and times that should be used for the students with special access. Choose the students who will receive this special access. Save your way out until you are in the list of assignment submission folders again. Let's see it. To set up special access for assignments, go to the Assignment tool and edit an assignment where special access is needed. In this case, the student needs an additional week to complete each written assignment, so each of these assignments will need to be edited. Edit Submission Folder. Go to the Restrictions tab. So far, what I'm seeing is the dates that apply to everyone. So I don't want to change this. I click Add Users to Special Access. And notice, there is above that button, there are two choices for the kind of special access. The default is the one that you will almost always need. Allow users with special access to submit files outside the normal availability dates for this folder. The second option will only allow special access students to access the assignment. That's not what we want. We just want to give different conditions for a specific student. So I leave the default in place and I click Add Users to Special Access. Now I will be able to set special dates for the student that I choose. The student who requires special access, Ronald needs an additional week. The start date is not going to change for Ronald, but we're going to change both the due date and the end date. Add a week to each one. And the end date, also add a week. And we have checked the name of the student who gets this special access, and we click Save. Now we save and close. And here we are back in the list of assignment submission folders. We can edit the next one. And that's all there is to it for assignments. Here are the steps for special access in quizzes. Go to the other tools menu and choose quizzes. Click on the name of a quiz to edit it. In the restrictions tab, click add users to special access. Choose the dates that should be used for the particular students with the special access. Choose the time limit for the students with special access. If a different number of attempts should be available to the students with special access, choose the attempt number. Choose the students who will receive this special access. Click Add Users to Special Access and save your way out. Let's see it. To set up special access for quizzes, go to Other Tools, Quizzes. Edit the quiz that needs special access. Special access is found in the Restrictions tab. The dates and conditions we see here in the Restrictions tab are not special access. They apply to everyone, and we don't want to change those. Instead, we scroll down and we allow selected users special access to this quiz. Add users to special access. Now, these settings will apply to special access when we set them. Our student needs an extra week for the quiz to be available and needs time and a half while taking the quiz. Let's set that up. First, we're going to extend the end date by a week. Now, the timing. If we had no changes, we'd leave it alone. If the special access was unlimited time, we would bullet this choice. But what we need to do is give time and a half, so that's in the enforced time limit. 30 minutes is the regular time. Time and a half would be 45 minutes. The grace period is the elapsed time allowed between clicking submit and the submission being received. If we needed to, we could also adjust the grace period. Another quiz setting that can be adjusted in Special Access is late behavior. What happens if the student exceeds the time limit? If you needed to change that, you could. And finally, how many attempts is the user allowed? In regular access, students in this class get 2 tries at the quiz. If the student needing special access were allowed a different number of attempts, we would check override attempts and change that to something else. As it is, we've made the changes that we need. The dates of availability and the time available to the student to take the quiz. Now the only thing we need to do is choose the student who gets this special access. And then we click Add Special Access. And we save our way out. Now the quiz we were just editing has a key by it. And the key means special access has been given to specific individuals on this quiz. And that's all there is to setting up special access in a quiz. Let's review. In both assignments and quizzes, to set up special access, you edit the tool item, go to the Restrictions tab, choose to add special access. Then you adjust the settings for a specific student or students on a special access screen. And finally, save your way out. If you have any questions about accessibility or special accommodations, please contact the NLU Library and Learning Support at 312-261-3188 or visit their website or email ada@nl.edu. For technical support with D2L Special Access, call the NLU Help Desk at 866-813-1177. Thank you.